Naked Massacre 1976, you'll find it on IMDb by a different name, which is Born for Hell. Okay, disturbed Vietnam vet ends up in Ireland during the troubled times, and then he ends up doing some really bad things with some nurses and whatnot. Typical of the 1970s in this kind of film, your slasher type film in the 1970s. There's a little bit of nudity, a little bit of sexuality, and a whole lot of disappointment. This took an entirely long time to get to the point, and it was very lame, very poorly acted the entire time. The guy was completely unbelievable, for one thing, in his role, and he seemed to be entirely bored the entire time. So, yeah. Anyways, not a great film. 3 out of 10. A Streetcar Named Desire, 1951. This is one of those movies you wonder how, in that time frame, did this get released and people didn't go, "Oh my God!" So, yeah, anyways, to today's standard, it's not really that bad. But yeah, there is something in this movie that happens that I can't say because the YouTube bots won't like me saying the word. But Stanley does something bad to the one woman and whatnot. This is basically an abusive relationship, and the woman keeps coming back. It's a very passionate relationship, though, and it's it culminates in that scene where he's standing there and he rips his shirt and he screams, "Stella!" And she comes down the stairs from the apartment upstairs and she's like, "Oh, Stanley," it's basically that's the pinnacle of their relationship. They're very passionate, even though it's a lot of tension between them and a lot of inappropriate stuff happening in their lives. Interesting side note, during the beginning of this film, she's just got off the Streetcar Named Desire, and which is a real streetcar, an actual real streetcar. Anyways, she gets off and she's in a very bad part of town, and there's debauchery and bars and it's everything like that going on and prostitutes, and you see this nun leading a group of young girls in white dresses, looks like they're ready for church. It's in the middle of the night too, it's late at night, and it just doesn't fit, and it's just completely surreal. I always wonder why they put that in there, and it's just for the contrast or what? Is it a symbol of the lost innocence of the woman who was violated? I don't know, but yeah. Anyways, 9 out of 10. A Streetcar Named Desire, 1984 TV movie. Anyways, made for TV type movie. Anyways, same basic premise, only not as harsh, not as gritty, not as dark. And they sort of fluffed it up a bit for the 1980s TV market. They would have to. So, anyways, and none of the symbolism that you got in the other one, none of the film noir edginess. Anyways, it's kind of worth watching, but not horribly worth watching. 6 out of 10. Grease, 1978. You can catch this one out on Stars as of the time that I made this video. By the way, I'm doing these all at the same time. That's why the light is not changing. I watched movies all day, and this is what I'm doing now is reviewing them. So, anyways, Grease, 1978. This is a classic movie of its kind. It's a musical. It's really quite an interesting musical, in fact. There's a lot of good acting in this. It's really, really a good movie. One of the best of its kind. Gotta say, it's not too racy or anything like that, so it's very. It's almost family appropriate. Maybe not quite if you're really a staunch person, but most families would enjoy this movie, I think. You might have to explain a few things to the kids, but yeah, anyways. Scratch that. Don't show the kids this movie. Anyways, 8 out of 10. You betcha. Really, really a cool movie. You gotta watch this at least once in your life. American Graffiti 1973. This is a coming of age movie, basically, and it's really a fun movie, too. Basically, it's a group of teenagers that have gotten together one last time before they go their separate ways to college and whatnot. Well, the one isn't going to college, but the others are. And, there's a lot of debauchery going on here. They get really a little out of hand and whatnot, and there's a little bit of inappropriateness between the one character and a younger person. That nothing really happens, but she really shouldn't be in the car with him, if you ask me. But yeah, anyways, this is another classic movie that's really worth watching, and something you should see at least once in your life. Once again, anyways, 7 out of 10. Wolfman Jack's in this. I do believe that's Wolfman Jack. This was actually the first one I watched of the Mask. Yeah, I think it was Wolfman Jack. Anyways, yeah, so there is a sequel to Grease and a sequel to this movie, and you don't want to watch either one of those. Yippers! Broken by Nine Inch Nails, 1993. Now, I severely recommend you do not watch this movie, or this short, because it is profoundly disturbing, and I mean that in the harshest terms. It is hyper-realistic violence. It looks like an actual snuff film. It looks and feels just like an actual snuff film. Basically, in this, it's an EP version of the song Broken, or of Broken, and it's a man who's kidnapped, or a young man who's kidnapped, supposedly a male prostitute. And he's being tortured to death and violated in an extreme fashion. Is forced to watch Nine Inch Nails videos, which in their own right are disturbing. It's a hellscape of a short film, and it's like I say, hyper realistic, hyper violent, and extraordinarily disturbing on a profound level. Yippers, for what it is, I'm giving this a 10 out of 10.